thank you so much for joining this week on The Word with Adelle. And of course, today I have good news for you, as I always do. So come on back. Thank you so much for joining me this week. Brother Festus has been ministering at our church for the past couple of days, and he's had a phenomenal time. And he's been ministering, telling us what the greatest need for the hour is. And indeed, it is the greatest need. As he shared and as he opened up his heart and shared what the Lord has shown him, indeed, it really is. And that's what I want to share with you today, because it's not just for our church, but it's for the body of Christ universal. But before we get into this word that's for the church, I want you to tell us a little bit about yourself. You're originally from Nigeria.
Yes, I'm a Nigerian by birth. And in 1991, September 10th, the Lord appeared to me in a vision and told me that in 1993, I should go to Czech Slovakia. Then, so Czech Slovakia, and I become Czech and Slovak Republics. And I should go there in 1993, and from there, I would do missionary works. So since 1993, I've been a missionary in the Czech Republic. I've been also traveling extensively to different parts of the world. I just finished a conference in February in Cameroon. So I travel here and there, preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. But I live with my family in the Czech Republic.
Beautiful wife and three children.
Yes, I got a boy and two girls.
Yes. I want you to share a little bit about your experience, though, when you first went to the Czech Republic, how God supernaturally, because you weren't really equipped and prepared. I mean, you needed
I didn't really know anybody.
You were sort of like the first black man.
in some of the regions, I was basically the only black person in the region, way back. But it's not, things have changed
now.
Yes. But for sure, it was totally different and difficult, and different culture. Coming from Africa, going to a place that's been very cold, sometimes you get minus 20 degrees Celsius, it's not even that high. So it was fighting and being, different. But with the sense of mandate and calling, and God's grace, I was able to gradually get going for that one.
And how many churches you have over there now?
We have actually groups now in churches in up to 9 cities. So we call groups of churches. But we are still expanding to other places and doing extensive outreaches, conferences, camps, in the church planting in different cities.
So you come with the experience of knowing God's voice, hearing God's voice, and seeing God move.
Absolutely. I have always, in all meetings that I have in different parts of the world, I have always, in all the places, seen amazing work of God. Life transformed, people saved, healings, miracles. I've seen all kinds of miracles and healings, deliverance, all the meetings. God is merciful, God is kind, God wants to bring people to the experience.
Okay, so let's talk about the greatest need in this hour.
It's from the beginning of the year, this year, the Lord gave me a message from the beginning of this year. And He has impressed that in my heart so deeply. And the message is the of peace. God wants humans to know peace. His peace is a shalom. To understand peace, to know peace, to walk in the heart of peace. But the gospel of Jesus Christ is the gospel of peace. But most of the people in the world do not know what peace is all about. And people define peace in their own way.
How does God define it?
Well, you see, peace in God's word actually means shalom. Shalom means actually at one, whole, com- complete, nothing broken, nothing missing. It has the connotation of content. You see, God doesn't need nothing. Doesn't need anybody to make him up. Doesn't need the pastor. Doesn't need the room. Doesn't need the sound. He is complete in himself. And God wants to bring us into that kind of sense of being complete in himself. That's what is called shalom. Nothing broken, nothing missing. At one. And God wants we as his people to come to the place of shalom. A place of nothing missing. Nothing broken, complete. At one.
Now, a scripture that you use.
Yes, chapter 6 and
chapter 6 and 4. Because it shows us there that peace is being taken out of Europe.
Absolutely. It is chapter 6 of Revelation, verse 4, you say there. And there went out another host that was red, and power was given to the Sabia to take peace from earth, and that they should kill one another. And there was given unto them. So, peace taken from the earth.
And it's like this gradually will soon happen.
Disappear.
Yeah.
You know, so this spirit was given power. This Australia was given power to take peace from the earth. To take, number one, the peace that he was to take from the earth is the knowledge of the truth. So, it takes the knowledge of the true peace of the earth. So people can live on false peace or false assumption as if they know what peace is. But doesn't really know what peace is. So it's given to him that and to turn men against themselves. So they will kill one another. That means a season of peace.
Which is
where we are. So they will kill each other, they will scare each other,
yeah.
They will frighten each other,
mm-hmm.
They will intimidate each other.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody begins to feel, basically you fear your neighbor. You fear everybody and anything around you.
Mm-hmm.
So you live in a state of panic,
mm-hmm.
and fear,
mm-hmm.
and confusion.
And anxiety.
That horse rider is now riding on the earth,
yes.
To take peace from the earth, where you cannot trust anybody or anything. You live in the state of fear, panic, and trepidation.
And it's so interesting what you said, because he's taken the knowledge,
yes.
of the true peace,
yes.
from the earth,
yes.
and without the knowledge of peace, you don't know what to look for.
You don't even know what peace is. Most people doesn't even know what peace is.
Yes.
If you ask somebody what is peace, he defines it in his own way. Somebody will say, well, if I will, you know, have all the money that I need, and I'll have peace.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody will say, well, I mean, to a drug addict, peace is when you have your fix.
Yeah.
You know, so people have some people, their peace is their religion.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
But you see, Jesus said,
"Hi, friends.
My peace
Pastor
I give
Lawson
unto
Badu from Caris Christian Center.
Mm-hmm. Not
so
as the world, not the kind of peace
God's
the world is
heart
offering
radio.
To you.
We know that the
my
heart of God
own
is the message
shalom.
Of grace
mm-hmm.
and unconditional
I
love.
Mm-hmm.
My
we know
own
that
completeness
you get a hold of that
and
message of grace
and
unconditional
mm-hmm.
love.
I
totally
give my own kind of
your
peace.
Life.
Mm-hmm. The peace I live with while I live here
sharing.
On earth.
If you have more
you see, Christ
about
had
that,
peace here on earth, which was unique in him and for him only.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, the men around him could not understand the kind of peace he was exhibiting. They don't know that kind of peace. But I want you to know my own kind of peace.
Mm-hmm.
Not the peace that was there in Israel then, or
yeah.
Politics or religious peace, but the shalom, the peace he brought to himself in here on earth. And he wants every believer to know peace, to enter into the cycle of peace which Christ brought to you on earth. And that peace is a miracle can only come by revelation of Jesus Christ. He is the Prince of Peace.
So what people are running from is really what they need to
absolutely. And the time is coming, and now is the time when people will travel thousands of miles not to see a superstar or a Hollywood actor. They will run around to see a person. Because people will pay anything to just see somebody that knows this peace that Christ is talking about. We are not very aware of that.
So let's look at another scripture. You just read John 14:27.
Yes. My peace I give unto you.
Right.
That's his legacy. Mm-hmm. My peace I give unto you.
And that's our inheritance.
That's our inheritance. Any believer, mm-hmm. any person who says he's a believer mm-hmm. and does not know this shalom, mm-hmm. this peace, does not know Christ. Now you can know the scripture. Now you can be religious. Mm-hmm. Now you can go to church. Now you can sing and dance. Mm-hmm. But if you've not entered into this cycle of shalom, mm-hmm. you don't know Christ. And most Christians today are in crisis. They are in confusion. They are in chaos. They are busy trying to find things outside to fulfill themselves. But you see, this shalom is when you are complete in yourself, where you are at peace no matter where or what.
Right, no matter what the circumstances, no matter what you're facing, no matter what you're dealing with.
Yes, yes, yeah. yes. My peace I give unto you. Mm-hmm. Not as the world gives away.
Right, right. So how would a person, let's talk about believers. They should have it. But a lot of them don't. Why?
Because some of them don't really understand the gospel. You see, many of the people today do not know the message of the gospel. The message of the gospel is the message of peace. Number one, you are at peace with God. God is the God of peace.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says, the God of peace will soon lose Satan under your feet. The God of peace that brought Adelle from the dead, that raised him out of the sheep, Jesus Christ. So he is the God of peace. So, and before you can have the peace of God, you must first of all make peace with God. Sin is declaring war on God. When you are living your own way, doing your own things, speaking your own words, thinking your own thoughts, pursuing your own passions, you are in conflict with the Most High. So you have to first of all make peace with God. That's why I cried that on the cross, to offer his blood to be the blood of reconciliation between God and man. So we must first of all make peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Basically surrendering, saying, Father, I don't want to be at war with you anymore. I want to live in harmony with you.
I want you to do me a favor. Just talk to the audience that's watching.
You see, so it's a person. The biggest curse for a person on earth is not the color of your skin. It's not if you have money or you don't have money. It's not if you have education or not. It's not even where you live on earth or your status. It's not even if you are even living the street. The biggest chaos for a human life is when a person's soul does not know peace. And you may be out there, and you have tried anything you can to find peace. I mean, some people try looking for peace in a religion. Some try looking for peace in love or in some relationship.
In a bottle.
You know, people are looking for peace in all the things of misery. So you can be looking for peace in a religion, in organization, in rules and regulations and do's and don'ts. There's no peace in heaven. Jesus Christ is the only source of peace. And I'm not saying this to condemn any other religion. I'm not saying this because I'm a Christian. This is the truth. Jesus Christ is peace. Religion can never give you peace. Jesus Christ is the peace. And if you have Jesus Christ, you have peace, number one, with God. Number two, you have peace with yourself. There's nothing in this life that a man or a woman will have peace with himself.
You are content.
You have no moral conflict.
Mm-hmm.
You are not being beaten by your own conscience.
Mm-hmm.
You see, your conscience can beat your brains out till you die, till you commit suicide.
Mm-hmm.
When you let Jesus come in and become the Prince of Peace in your life, you have peace with God. You can lift your hands to heaven to look guilt and condemnation.
Mm-hmm.
You can look into yourself and there's no guilt and condemnation. And you can look around you and your neighbor. You have nothing against anyone. The people are trying to be in harmony with medicine. They want to do meditations, they want to do all kinds of religious cultic things to come into it. What a drama in Poland. Harmony with medicine. Harmony with creation. Is when you are in peace with the God of creation. Jesus is the Prince of Peace. The devil will let you do anything you want to do with religion. Long as you don't know truth, you can satisfy. And I was told that in the church, and I was having a Christian some years ago in one of the cities in Czech Republic, and my posters were all over the city, with all over the house. So nobody knew about it. You know, in that area, sometimes you can hardly see a black person. So while I was going to the meeting that in the open air, someone put a question to me. It was a skinhead looking for me there by the Christian. So he's looking for a person to do actually kill. So what I did do that, I just laughed. I said, he's gonna be my first time. God is my witness. As I walked to that stage, took the microphone, within 5 minutes I spoke, the big boy, big guy, split down and attended. I mean, he was sobbing so deeply. Within so short time, I was hugging him, he was hugging me, he was kissing me, but he was calling his mom and they said, "Mom, you know what I'm doing here? I'm kissing the black man. I'm kissing the black man." What happened? Shalom. Mm-hmm. Peace is stronger than war.
Amen.
He was prepared for war, mm-hmm. but not prepared for peace.
Mm-hmm.
Peace overcame him.
Mm-hmm.
The glory of Shalom,
mm-hmm.
the power of the peace of God,
mm-hmm.
conquered his life. Because what is he looking for? He is looking for peace. I'm telling you. Most of the people that are at war are looking for peace.
Mm-hmm.
If they would see peace, they would take it.
Mm-hmm.
But the issue is nobody's offering them the peace. So they think the only way out is war. Jesus Christ, by his peace, imagine when they came to arrest him in the garden with the knives and dogs and everything. When they came to him, he said, "Who are you looking for?" They said, "Jesus of Nazareth." He said, "I am he." All of them went backward and fell off. Oh my God, I pray that wherever you are in your life, that you might welcome Jesus. When it is a shalom, take peace to your life. You will disarm your warring husband. You will disarm the people around you. Just find peace. Find his presence. The presence of you will just melt and paralyze all the foes around you. I'm your friend. Not your body. And you will become it more was broken, by peace.
It was broken. Well, that word was for you. And I'm encouraging you to give us a call. 774-4904. I will pray with you. I will pray with you. And break the power of the devil from over your life. Because you find it away what God really wants. The devil is trying to hide what truth he is. And Brother Fester said, "Peace is coming.
Everything.
because they felt they were in bondage.
Mm-hmm. You see, they should have excluded. I'm a comedy center. Mm-hmm. The people were so limited. Mm-hmm. You know, and if I just go to the shops, you can hardly, you find some, you can only buy maybe one stick of banana. You can't just buy all that you want. Don't even have the money anywhere. Mm-hmm. So with the fall of communism, the people who has felt that they've been entrapped for so many years, they wanted a taste of freedom. Mm-hmm. And truly, they didn't really know what freedom was or what it would look like.
Yes.
So,
yes.
And then when the gospel started coming, they begin to hear about God, Jesus, heaven, and Bible, and how to live your life. Somehow, they thought that freedom is nobody should tell you what to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, nobody should tell you how to live your life.
Yeah.
So they were looking for that kind of freedom, which is defined by the walls. And finally, money started coming from all over the world. You know,
the
banks, firms came. They start having jobs. You can borrow the money. You can take a loan. So they said, "Wow, this is the freedom." But we are in a time now when that whole thing now is what collapses. The hopes of the utopia on earth is going down. So people don't really know now what next. They have seen what America can provide. They have seen what can come from the West. They have seen the mixture of everything, the confusion, the chaos, the fear, and the unsustainability of the forces of this world. So I think this is a time to tell the gospel. Jesus is the only source of freedom.
Sense also to you said that one of the things that you share is the fact that you see some people, I mean, they just lose all sense of hope.
Absolutely.
And they hang out publicly, they
absolutely. People are, it's happening all over the place. It's amazing because, in fact, sometimes you can see that even the poorest part of the world, there are less suicide in the poorest part of the world than even the more developed part of the world. Because, you see, the Bible says that God has given the poor of the world rich in faith. So you can see some poor guy in there, somewhere, having nothing to eat. But you see, he has a lot of hope, he has a lot of faith, he has a peace of God. Then you see a professor that lost his job somewhere in Europe, hanging himself, because he has no faith in God, he has no peace of God. So we are in such a crisis time. And unless we are able to communicate with people to enter into the peace which Christ offers,
that's the message of the hour.
That's the message of the hour. The peace comes about. Your death will nothing missing, nothing broken. Because sometimes people think that the peace we are talking about is peace where you have peace and you have nothing. No. The crisis we have in the world is not because of a lack of nothing. It is because of a lack peace. When you have shalom, everything you have is intact. Your mind is intact. Your body is intact. Your health is intact. Your family, your marriage is intact. In fact, the world is disintegrating. Not because of lack of money, but because of lack of peace. Because without peace, nothing holds everything together. Peace is what holds, is the glue that keeps everything together. If you have no peace, you will lose everything. So God can keep everything.
Let's look at a couple more scriptures. You already talked about Acts 10:36, where it says the word which God sent to the children of Israel.
Preaching peace by Jesus Christ. Offering peace by Jesus Christ. You see, people believers are offering peace by other people, by other names, by other institutions.
Mm-hmm.
God's peace is offered only through and in and by Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The true heavenly peace is only offered in Christ Jesus. One of the crises of our time is the workings of Satan and Lucifer. You see, Lucifer understands the human weaknesses. He uses our differences to divide us and to destroy us. Oh, you're a woman. Oh, he's a man. So let's look for a woman's way to peace. The man's way to peace. The Arab way to peace. The black way to peace. So the Jewish way to peace. The devil understands our differences. So he exploits them and forms religion based upon our differences, and thereby robbing us of the only source of peace, which is Jesus Christ. Peace. Peace is not a Jew. Peace is not black. Peace is not white. Peace is peace. It's heavenly peace. It's only found in Jesus Christ. And it's for every man or woman anywhere on earth. Hallelujah.
Amen. And listen, if you need, you heard the word today, you heard the word of peace. Today, if you've never made Jesus Lord of your life, if you've never received that peace, because peace is a man, Jesus.
It's a person.
It's Jesus.
Peace has a name.
Yes, yes. If you've never made Jesus Lord of your life, today do it. So you can have his peace, you can have peace with God, and you can also have his peace, and you'll be content. So say this prayer after me. I'm a sinner, Father God. I admit and I confess I've sinned against you. I've fallen short, and I ask you to forgive me. Cleanse me. Wash me. Give me your life. Give me your peace. Live big within me. Change me. I want to be and do what you desire. And I thank you for giving me a heart of peace. I thank you I'm no longer at war with you. I'm no longer at war with myself. I receive your peace today through Jesus Christ. And I thank you for changing me. I thank you for your peace dwelling within me. I thank you, Father, for your eternal peace. In Jesus' name.
When you took my place.
Listen, give us a call. 774-4904. You prayed that prayer. Give us a call. We have more materials we'd like to give you, we'd like to share with you. Again, the peace of God is yours. Amen. That's what the Bible says. And the peace of God, as a matter of fact, for believers, you believers, the word of God says, be anxious for nothing. But in everything, with prayer and supplication and thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And the peace of God that passes all understanding will guard and keep your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus. So peace is yours today. Receive it. God bless you. Thank you so much for joining me this week. Look forward to seeing you next week.